Now including Hermani. Welcome. It's Hermani in the morning show, filmed before a live studio audience. Good morning to you, my friends. Good day, esteemed friends, colleagues, étrangers out there, whom we will one day meet. You are tuned in to the show that brings you the realness of reality and realty. No fake news. Bringing you current events and insider real estate tips to your home, to your vehicle, to your phone, and wherever you are, whomever you are. It's the Herman Hermani Show. So, today we have many treats in store for you. A special exclusive interview from some big high-ranking official at the White House. Surprise. As well as the world's sexiest man, 2018, Ryan Reynolds. And the nation's health expert, Dr. Fauci. But our wonderful production team here at 106.1, we'd really like to share with you a compilation of the hottest interviews of the year, including my scathing interviews and exposés with Mr. Joe Rogan, Dr. William Cosby, and someone you may know, he's been hot on the presses lately, Donald J. Trump. But first, a word from our sponsors. Hit it, Johnny.
I'm Zai Sperling, president of Hair Club for Men. If you've ever thought about doing something about your thinning hair, then this important new booklet is something you should have. And I'll see that you get it free if you call our toll-free number. It covers the good and not-so-good points of toupees and wigs, weaves, the suture process, transplants, and a lot more. So call now for your free copy. And by the way, I'm not only the hair club president, but I'm also a client.
Yes, you're in tune to 106.1. Stay tuned. We've got a few more commercials coming, but stick around. We got some surprises for you. Yeah, guys. Yeah. Hey, this is the club for hair. A hair club for people. The club everyone with a hip hairdo is talking about. Jerry curl, mullet, mohawk, fro, fade, or emo bangs. Come hang with the hair homies at the club for hair. This is the Biker Club for Hairy Men. We, former members of the biker gangs, but we're transformed. We're getting you off of fossil fuels and getting you into bicycles so you can feel the feels and not feel the fuels. Keep your heart hard. Keep your butt stuck to the seat and keep rocking on the road. Join us, the Biker Club for Hairy Men. Yeah. Oh, so thank you to our interns, Johnny and Ronald, for putting together our advertisements and connecting with our sponsors using a new advertising algorithm that they created themselves in their mother's garage. Thanks again, Johnny and Ronald. Truly couldn't do it without you. It's the Herman Hermani in the Morning Show. Now let us cut to a compilation of the hottest interviews of the year, starting with listeners' fan favorite, my interview with Mr. Joe Rogan. We discussed masculinity and the need for a society to understand what it is to be a man. Let us cut to this. So thank you, Joe Rogan, for joining us. Please share, what is your wisdom about manhood?
Is that hard times create hard men. Hard men create soft times. Soft times create soft men. Soft men create hard times.
So this is fascinating. And Father Time? Would Father Time be hard or soft man?
Yeah, well, what about Hillary? What about Bill? What about this? What about that?
But what about these men who really capture the imaginations of so many progressives in our society? Like, let's say, Senator Bernie Sanders or this Mahatma Gandhi. I mean, these guys, they cannot even lift 300 pounds. What do you think about these men?
You should be a monster. You said you should be a monster. You should be ruthlessly ambitious and then learn how to control it. And it's that old expression. It's better to be a warrior in a garden than a gardener in a war. It's an old expression, but it makes sense. Because it doesn't mean that you can't be kind if you're strong. But it does mean you can't be strong if you're weak.
If you're fascinating. Mr. Joe Rogan, thank you. I never thought about it this way. And you've changed my life. As I believe you've changed our listeners. Forever. Thank you so much. What would we do without you? And we're back. Now, coming up, most anticipated interview of the 21st century, Herman Hermani's interview with R. Kelly. This was a controversial one, but as we take a look back at the year, we see the importance of investigative journalism and hard-pressing interviews that our show, One and Only, does. Now, let's take a look at that interview. Yes, Mr. R. Kelly, thank you for sitting down with me. Oh, don't you know? Don't you know? I'm very happy to be here. I, R. Kelly, love to share my voice with the people. Yes, so Mr. Kelly, tell me about yourself. How did you get started? Well, you know, when I was on the streets of Glasgow, me and my boys, we would sing a song just to get by. And they always told me, hey, Ronald, you need a special name so the marquee can put your name up and everyone can hear your voice. You have the voice of an angel. And I said, hey, don't call me Ronald no more. Call me R. Kelly. I come from a line of Kellys. Generations of hard-working Irishmen. We made it all the way over to Scotland just to sing to the King of Scotland. We made it here now, and now we're from the bottom, we made it to the top. We're here in the US now. Thank you to my people. Yes, so R. Kelly, I hear that you started out singing at halftime shows for football games. Tell me, who's your favorite football team? 49ers or Raiders? Oh, you stupido American. You people think you play a football. You play a handball. Me and my boys, we played with the Liverpool. We played with the Manchester. We sang in the locker room. We sang when those boys were taking a shower after a hard fought game in the rains of Glasgow. You people, you know nothing about the sports and athleticism. I, R. Kelly, have made my name through the athleticism of my voice. Oh, I'm so sorry. Yes, this interview is done. I'm out of here. I don't do interviews with you. Gotcha, journalism. Case closed. And as you heard, it was quite a tense interview. But we did the best we could, and the people got to see what they got to see. Let's move on to a commercial.
I believe I can buy a ticket just to fly. Ryanair, it's a discount fare. Ryanair take you everywhere, from Ireland to Scotland. And to the Irish Isles of Jamaica, too. And to your American pen pals, Scotland, in Missouri, Oh yeah. We believe you can fly. Hello, friends. This is Ronald Kelly. Come fly the friendly airs with Ryanair. And welcome back, friends. Hey, now the most anticipated interview of the year. Herman Hermani interviews Dr. Antonia Facini.
And some content still needs to be edited by our fact-checking department, whom all, unfortunately, came down with cough and flu-like symptoms after this recording with the doctor. Please check back soon for editorial updates. And now, we are pleased to announce a special guest for this episode. From the NIH, your go-to doc over the last 3 years, the one and only Dr. Anthony Faucini. Yeah.
Hey, wow, that's probably the nicest thing anyone said to me, aside from your mother last night.
Hey, doc, you're so silly. I'm so glad you're happy to be here, but I don't get the reference.
Forget about it, little guy.
Okay. I still can't believe our interns got you booked for our little grassroots podcast.
Oh, you know, I get around like Tupac.
Who? Tupac? And anyways, let's dive right into some questions I have. Oh gosh, oh goodness. Okay, I promise this wouldn't happen. Okay, to be real with you, I'm kind of nervous being here with a nation's top doc. I'm such a fan, doc. Gosh. Okay, it looks like my question sheet is a little too soggy. I shouldn't have placed that in my front pocket. Okay, let's just jump over to the questions that our listeners posted on the Twitter page. Okay, let's see here. Johnny McDougall writes, when did you know your destiny to become a famous doctor for the NIH?
Hey, well, you see, I was reading the Reader's Digest on the John in the Poughkeepsie Public Library when I overheard a guy on the John in the stall next to me talking to his doctor on the phone. And the doctor recommended to him to take public health classes online at the Phoenix University web series online courses. And his doctor, Dr. Oz, or Wizard of Oz or something, he was like saying he'd get a commission or something. So it's like win-win, you know? You get your degree, you get some money. Soon as I exit the loo, I checked out the website for this college in the clouds. And I see that for only $99.99, I could become a doctor of philosophy. And you know, hey, I'm thinking, hey, I did community college in Philadelphia. Why can't I become a doctor of the philosophia? You know what I mean? Hey, so what did you say about the NEH? Oh, yes, doc, I believe I was asking about the esteemed NIH. For which you are the lead doctor?
Oh, you mean Annie H. Yeah, she was hot and steamy, you're right. Well, even though I was married at the time, I thought, how many chances in life does one have to meet Jimmy Hoffa's daughter, Annie? And it was on the Jersey Shore, you know? So I go up to her and ask her if she wants to...
Doc, how did you get into this business?
Well, it's a family business, you know? My family had some mobsters who needed medical care after some deals went south and some guys got, you know, they got wounded. They got, you know.
Whoa. Doctor, did they get bitten by the lobsters?
Hey, what? Lobsters? Who? What? No, I said mobsters.
Oh, so like the Loch Ness monsters?
No, kid, I said mobsters.
I don't understand.
Like the mafia.
Okay, doc, I'm not following. So, let's first rewind. You're with John and Lou, and you catch word about this fellowship to become a doctor?
Hey, no rewinding.
No rewinding, buddy. Don't bring up my past or my PTSD traumatics, kid. I'm telling my story, kid. Oh, yes, Doc. My apologies. Please do carry on. Yeah, so I start the classes online. They take too much time, and my ma's Wi-Fi keeps going down when I'm in the garage, you know, in my man cave, you know, and I'm like, yada, yada, yada. I slipped my cousin Joey Butterfuku a few Benjamins to take some of the classes for me, and bada bing, bada boom, bada boom, you know, I'm an official doctor of philosophy, yeah. Hey, congratulations. You must really enjoy pondering the mysteries of the universe and all of humanity's questions with the nation's top doctors.
Precisely. I got so many philosophers' questions and health concerns, too. Like, for example, like the corona mighty sharona thingamabob going on right now. Is it real? And if it's so, is it winding down? And can we shake hands? Can we hug? What's the deal? And while we're on it, other questions like these ones. Like, if McDonald's sells Happy Meals, does that mean that a person can buy happiness? And if so, will a double Whopper with cheese help or hinder my high cholesterol? But will it also make me happy? You know, I don't know.
Fascinating thoughts, Doc. But first, we have to take a quick break for station identification and a word from our sponsors. And we're back. Thank you for sticking with us. You're tuned into the Hermani Show, morning show. And that was Johnny. Johnny, where are my notes? You said you were going to write the notes in the script. And so that was Jerry Brown with a song titled I Feel. Yeah. So our next episode, we'll sit down with Bernie Madoff. And stay tuned for that. Okay, good. Thank you. We have correction. Good. So that song was titled I Feel Good from John. Who is it? Write it down for me, okay? Okay, from Charlie Brown. Yes, classic. Now, to a sneak preview of our upcoming segment on my interview with Sexiest Man Alive, Ryan Reynolds. So, tell me, Mr. Reynolds, how was your recent trip to the island of Hermione to film Pokemon? Mr. Reynolds, when you visit the wonderful island of Hermione, do you take a lot of photos and get souvenirs?
I take a crap load of pictures, but it's the digital age, so it's like, you know, my dad took, I mean, hundreds of thousands of photos. Like, not of us.
Oh, wow.
I'm 18 years old, and in the middle of the dinner once, I grabbed the camera, and I went to the bathroom, and I just...
Okay, Reynolds, let's move on. We will come to a commercial and continue this later. Thank you, Johnny. Okay, now let's go to a few commercials. Johnny, please roll the commercials.
The charity concert of the year, coming to the Oakland Coliseum, December 31st. Featuring Naughty by Nature, MC Hammer, bringing awareness to OCD. Charity fundraising for those who need it most. OCD, an epidemic of obsessive proportions. CD, 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 CD.
Hey guys, this is Billy Bean. Come join us at the Oakland Coliseum, December 31st, raising awareness for mental health and OCD. One thing you can touch is your phone right now. Dial and order tickets to see Naughty by Nature, MC Hammer, Lil Wayne, and raise awareness for mental health and OCD. Thank you.
Hey, this is Lil Wayne. Call 1-800-510-415-123 to order your ticket now.
Hoping I can help anyone else out there who's dealing with any mental health problems.
And welcome back, listeners. Now we come into the best time of the show. Tip-top, best part, and towards the end. But we always wrap up with a few calls from our beloved listeners. Let's take a few calls before we wrap up here. All right, let's see here. Johnny, can you get the phones? Can you get the phone? Aloha. Okay, let's listen here. What's happening? Johnny, what's happening at the door? Johnny, please, at the door. We're trying to get Johnny, stop them from coming in. Hey, we're the proud mama's boys. We're coming to storm your show. You must stop this radio at once. Hey, guys, no. What are you doing? Hey, are you a bad man? We're accusing you, Hermione, of posing as a fake Italian. No, me? No. I'm just a man from the island of Romano. We were never annexed by Italy. You stole a paschetti from us and now you call it spaghetti. I don't want anything to do with you Italianos. Hey, no, Herman. You're taking our culture. You're commodifying it for your profit and for your radio show. You know, you're what they call a culture vulture. Hey, guys, come on now. Settle down. We can settle this like the times gentlemen. Hey, no. We will not certify this show. Stop it at once. Friends, stop. No, Herman. We're tired of your show. Friends, listeners out there, I must escape. Please, stay tuned until next week's program. I'm going to jump out this back door, but I'll survive. And we'll be back for next week's program when we will be speaking to dating expert Ivana Tinkle and fashion model Jock Strapp. Until then, toodaloo!
Station here in Austin facing a big fine after a federal crackdown. The Federal Communications Commission says a central Austin apartment with this 50-foot tower outside has been illegally operating as Liberty 90.1 FM. The FCC fined the owners, Walter and Imre Olnick, $15,000 for running an unlicensed radio station. They did not deny that they broadcast the signal on 90.1 FM, but they do claim they are not subject to U.S. law. So far, the radio station is still on the air. That antenna remains in place.